In this segment, we'll talk about check number two of finding out whether a particular linear regression model is adequate. And this is based on something called the standard error estimate. And we'll look into the definition of the standard error estimate in this video itself. So you don't need to know what standard, you do not need to have already known what standard error estimate is. So the actual check is that 95% of the residuals meaning the difference between the observed value and the predicted value, observed coming from the data which is given to you, predicted comes from model which you are using, they have to fall between plus minus 2 of the standard error estimate. So we are going to take an example in order to illustrate this particular check. So here we have six data points of alpha versus temperature given to us. And we were able to find a regression model for it by using our linear regression formulas. This is the intercept and this is the slope. And the first check which we talked about was to see that whether this particular straight line visually looks like that it is fitting the data, which it is if I was just looking at it visually. And now what we're going to do and see, the second check is more about these vertical distances which you have between the observed values and the predicted values, the observed values being these data points and predicting being the corresponding y value on the regression line. And it is all about trying to figure out whether these distances are too big or too small, and that's what we are going to be looking at. So the standard estimate is defined as the as this quantity right here, where SR is the sum of the square of the residuals divided by n minus 2, where n is the number of data points which are given to you. So what is SR? SR is the sum of the square of the residuals, as we were talking about that, hey, it is the vertical distance. Residuals and vertical distance are the same thing which we were talking about. The vertical distance between observed and predicted values is the same thing as the residuals. So this is the observed value, this is the predicted value. So what we are doing is subtracting the two quantities, squaring each one of them, and then adding all of them up. And what we are doing is, once we have calculated this quantity here, all we have to do is divide by n minus 2, and we get our standard error estimate. And the standard error estimate has these two variables which are next to it, alpha slash t. This is where the dependent variable goes, and this is where the independent variable goes. So that's just a way it is symbolized. Now, what does this standard estimate stand for? That's what's more important to understand. It is a measure of the variation of the observation which you have made, which are these alpha i's, and what you have predicted. So it is very similar concept, just like we had in standard deviation. If you remember your statistics class, you had standard deviation given as summation I is equal to 1 to n xi minus x bar whole square divided by n minus 1, where xi were your data values, x bar was the average. So you found the difference between the observed values and the average value. You squared those quantities, added them all up and divided by n minus 1. It's very similar here. You are taking the difference between the observed and the predicted values, squaring them up and adding them all up. Now, the big thing which we have to talk about is that this n minus 1 business. We have n minus 1 here because we have lost 1 degree of freedom from the use of the value, the average value, in the calculation of the standard deviation. What that simply means is that if the reason why it's n minus 1 is because if somebody gave me n minus 1 data points out of the n data points, he gave the numbers to me, then I can still calculate the value of the some other data point which is not given to me just from the average. It's very similar here, that the reason why it's n minus 2 here is because we have lost 2 degrees of freedom because of A0 and A1. What that simply means is that when you have x, y versus x data, or in this case, temperature versus alpha versus temperature data, that if somebody, let's suppose you are taking 6 points for this particular problem, and you have y which is given here, let's suppose somebody didn't give me these two data values. But if I knew what A0 and A1 are, I would be able to calculate these two values. And that's why we divide by n minus 2. The other thing is also here is that if we had only two data points, then it doesn't make any sense to calculate the value of the standard error estimate, because if you have two data points, you can simply draw a straight line which will go exactly right through the data points. Which is the same thing here. If I had one data point, there's no need to, the average value does not tell me anything else, and that's why there is an n minus 1 here. So having said that, the standard estimate is then is a measure of what is the variation between the observed values and predicted values. So you can very well see if all my data points were on the straight line itself, then the value of SR will be 0, hence this will be 0. So that makes sense that higher this number of standard estimate is, more the variation is. Just like when you talked about averages and standard deviation, higher the value of the standard deviation was, more is the variation of the data from the average value. So in order to calculate the standard estimate, what we have to do is we are going to use the regression curve, which has been derived by using the linear regression formulas. These are the six data points which we have here, and then I calculate these predicted values. These are my predicted values, and these are coming from A0 being 6.0325 and A0 being this value of 0.009 6964. So let's suppose if I was at minus 340, alpha at minus 340 will be equal to 6.0325 plus 0.009 6964 times minus 340, and that number here would turn out be 2.7357, and that's what we have here. So similarly, you calculate all these predicted values, and then what you are doing is you are subtracting these two values, because this is the observed value, this is the predicted value, and the difference between the two is the residual. So we have this as the residual, or you may call it the vertical distance between the observed value and the predicted values. So you can see that by calculating these residuals, all I have to do is take all these six residuals which I have here, square each one of them and add them up, and that will give me the sum of the square of the residuals. Then I will divide it by n minus 2 and take the square root, and that will give me the standard error estimate. So you can see that here, the sum of the square of the residuals, so we had six residuals in the previous slide, and if I square each one of them, that's the value which I get. Then all I do is divide by 6 minus 2, because 6 is the number of data points, 2 is in the formula there, and I get the standard estimate to be 0.25141. So what does this mean, this 2.25141? So that is an estimate of the variation of the data which I have. The way we look at it is as follows. What we do is, let's suppose these are the 6 data points which I had, and I was able to draw this particular regression curve, and I found this regression curve from my linear regression formulas. So what we're going to do now is that we are going to take 2 times the standard error estimate. This is 2 times the standard estimate, and we're going to draw another line, which will be this yellow line. So we are basically adding 2 times the standard error estimate to the intercept, and we are getting this line. Then we subtract 2 times the standard estimate right here, and we get this particular line. So all we have to do is now to see if 95% of the data points are between this blue line here and this yellow line here. And if that is the case, then we have a positive check, that the check does meet the muster here in terms of the data values which we have. However, if we are going to be doing this, let's suppose if we do this, let me write this down here. So we have the values, the 95% of the data points have to be between between minus 2 sy by x to plus 2 sy by x in terms of in terms of the data here. So however, what's going to happen is that so we're talking about the intercept being added to SYX and then intercept being subtracted to SYX. That's what we mean by that. However, you got to see that we cannot be doing this visually. Let's suppose somebody gives me 1,000 data points. I'm not going to start counting and seeing that if 950 points are between the top line and the bottom line. So we have to do this by using a computer, by writing a program for it. So how do we go about doing this? So we do this follows. What we do is we take the residual and we divide it by the standard estimate. And once we have taken the residual and divided by the standard estimate, then all we have to do is to figure out whether 95% of these scaled residuals are between minus 2 and plus 2. And this particular part can be put in a program as opposed to having to visually look that if 95% of our scaled residuals are between minus 2 and plus 2. So having said that, this is our standard estimate. We calculated the residuals from a previous slide where the six residuals, because we needed those to calculate our sum of the squared residuals in the standard estimate. But now what we have is we can calculate the scaled residual. What this scaled residual right here is, for example, is nothing but the residual, which is minus 0.28571 divided by the standard estimate, which is 2.141, and that's what this turns out to be. So similarly, we calculate all these scaled residuals, and you're finding out all the scaled residuals which you have calculated here are all between minus 2 and plus 2. Hence, it meets the check number 2, that 95% of my scaled residuals are between minus 2 and plus 2. So I'm hoping that you have been able to follow this check number 2, and that's the end of the